politicians use social media all the time to promote their appearances, speeches, or events. Well, at first glance, this looks like a normal advertisement on Instagram from Arizona Republican Congressman Paul Gosar. It's with the American Populist Union, an organization the Anti-Defamation League has called white supremacist. Well, after public criticism, the Gosar campaign claims that he never intended to speak at the event, but the Arizona Republic reported he was promoting it on social media. For the record, this is not the first run-in the congressman has had with white supremacist groups. For example, last year he took a trip with a small group of volunteers to southern Arizona to clean up trash. It looks like a group of normal everyday citizens just trying to do the right thing. But alongside him are a blogger who praised Nazi Germany, a congressional candidate who called for the execution of election officials, and a speaker removed from the 2020 RNC who shared an anti-Semitic conspiracy theory. In 2017, Gosar falsely suggested that the Charlottesville Unite the Right rally that left one person dead and dozens injured was actually a false flag operation by the left.
In fairness, Antifa's in the news because of a white supremacist rally in Charlottesville.
Well, isn't that interesting that maybe that was created by the left?
Do you think George Soros funded the neo-Nazis who marched in Charlottesville?
Wouldn't it be interesting to find out?
In 2018, Gosar dined with Philip de Winter. He is a far-right Belgian politician who once said Islam doesn't belong in Europe. Gosar's spokesperson has previously declined to comment on specific questions about the congressman's associates. There seems to be no accountability from party leadership. Here's what House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy said last month after Gosar and Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene spoke at a conference organized by a white nationalist.
There isn't no place for that. There's no place for what has gone on with that organization by far, and there never will be in this party, and it'll never be tolerated.
And obviously, Green and Gosar are already off their committees, but you said in November that you'd return them to their committees and muse that they might even get better committee assignments. Do you stand by that still?
They have the ability to be able to get committees based upon that time when it comes.
So to be clear, his speech was pre-recorded, and his team claims that it was sent by mistake. Gosar told Politico a staffer, quote, misconstrued directions and the tape was meant for another group. But McCarthy said last month that committees are still on the table for Gosar despite currently being stripped of all assignments and his further association with hateful groups. When there is a repeated pattern over years, how much longer can GOP leadership continue to turn a blind eye?